Paolo, thank you so much for inviting me to be a part of this beautiful initiative. It is such a blessing to be able to share. In these really wild, crazy, and unpredictable times, like many of you, I'm also confronted with many questions. I have very deep anxiety about what lies ahead. The uncertainties are at times overwhelming. And today I wanted to share with you a little bit about how I cope with that, and also how I use my process to actually take next steps. When I was actually thinking about recording this, I was kind of just taking a very long glance at my life, as I have plenty of time to do now. And what I noticed is that at several points in my life, I've been asked to redefine myself, to actually change the way that my entire life essentially changed, and the way that I was in my life had to change by necessity. And as I look back at all of these key pivotal moments in my life, there was one thing that was constant. And it was a question that I asked myself, and probably not in such clear words, but I always came to the point where I wanted to know what my truth was, right? What does my spirit want? What does my heart want to say? And when I got clear with this, then I knew how to proceed. Now I have a slogan, or you know, a mantra that I tell myself all the time: live your truth. And sometimes it's hard to know what your truth is, because the mind gets in the way, and you get you get a lot of messages from family, from society, saying yeah, you should be a certain way. And It's in this time, it's such a blessing, because all of those voices have quieted down, and now you have the opportunity to just listen to yourself. And when I was contemplating this, and a word, telos, came to mind. It's a Greek word that Aristotle used, and it means the goal of a thing, right? And so that everything out there has a purpose, including you, including me. And our life's journey is to discover this purpose. In yoga, we have a very similar word. It's called dharma. And at the root word of dharma is three, D-H-R-I. And it means that which supports from within. Now, I always visualize this, that concept, or that the essence of that concept, kind of like a light that never goes out. And whenever I get stuck, or I feel like I'm not sure which direction to go, I try to get quiet just so I can visualize that light and allow my mind to settle so that only that light is speaking to me. And then most often I have a clear direction that I want to move in. And so one of the things that allows me to go through this process in discovering my truth, or you know, who I am, it allows me to also shed who I am not. And this is, I think, very key for us in this time right now. I kind of look at it like, you know, we need to move forward naked. We've been carrying a lot of clothes. We put on all of our winter clothes, but we're going into summer, and we need to take it off one layer at a time. And this doesn't mean that we need to just, you know, say no to everything and get rid of everything and, you know, push everything away. No, instead, we need to get quiet and just observe and ask ourselves the question, you know, what serves us and what has served us? What has served us and no longer serves us? How do we begin the process of letting those things go? And you know, I'm just like you, and oftentimes I get stuck, and I'm not sure, that I have the strength to take the next step. And when I reach that point, or I have those moments, I try to practice some self-compassion. And I think this is also a skill that is absolutely essential in these times. You know, many of us are, I'm looking at social media like all of you, and I'm saying, fuck, I want that guy's life. You know, like, look, they're in isolation, but they're rocking it. Like, So we have to take a step back and recognize that we are doing the best that we can right now. And we are always doing the best that we can. Even when it feels like we're not, we are, because it's part of our nature. And it's part of this inherent desire within us to expand and be the most of who we can be. And I think in these times, that's exactly what life and circumstances are asking us to do, really to be the most of who we can be. And that doesn't mean perfect, and we will never be perfect, but we can always take steps into becoming more of ourselves. And this requires listening to the heart, nurturing the heart, opening up your heart and sharing yourself with the world around you. It might just be with your family and friends, and it might be in more expanded forms through social media. But right now, absolutely, it's so important that we all connect to our truth. So with that in mind, I invite you to live your truth and to seek your truth and do the best that you can. And sending you love and light wherever you are. And please stay healthy, stay safe. And don't forget to laugh daily, find positive things to watch, and just find reasons to stay inspired. You know, look around you, and life is really beautiful. And that's something that we must remember, is that this life is an absolute gift. And regardless of how this moment appears to us right now, even the opportunity to live this moment is an absolute blessing and an absolute gift, and may we make it so. So with that, sending you love and light, have a beautiful day wherever you are, and take care. Bye.